hello, 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 my fellow Midjourneyers and Midjourneyettes. This week, the developers added a new command to our beloved Midjourney: describe. In this video, we take an in-depth look at what it is, how it works, and what you need it for. In a nutshell, describe makes Midjourney go backward. Instead of your usual text-to-image process, you upload an image and Midjourney guesses a prompt. We already did a study on a similar free tool called CLIP Interrogator. I'll link it in the description below. Despite being made with focus on Stable Diffusion prompts, it works very well with Midjourney. It generates wordy, convoluted, and often nonsensical prompts. But the results are surprisingly close to the original. However, now we have a dedicated instrument for Midjourney and by Midjourney. So, in this video, we will also compare the two and try to answer the question if the built-in designated function works better than an external tool created for another text-to-image AI. But before we start, let's get the technicalities off the table. There are no additional parameters available for describe at the moment. Meanwhile, CLIP Interrogator offers three modes: best, classical, and fast. And setting for best mode max flavors. The number of keywords and expressions from 2 to 24 at which the AI will stop analyzing an image. For this study, I settled on a middle value of 12 flavors. Another difference is speed. Midjourney's describe is blazing fast, only a few seconds per image, whereas CLIP Interrogator demands 30 seconds to a couple of minutes, depending on the number of flavors and the complexity of your image. Using describe is super easy. You type /describe, hit enter, upload an image, and that's it. The result is four prompts in quite different styles that Midjourney guessed after analyzing your input. That gives you 16 various results for each of your source images. Now, this is my favorite part. When Midjourney finds an artist's style in the initial picture and adds their name to a prompt, that name often becomes a link to Google search. New artist? Explore them instantly. I wish it did the same for artistic techniques and art movements it mentions in the prompts. Maybe in the next version, huh, Midjourney? Finally, there is a generate button under each option that lets you quickly send the prompt to work. When you press it, Midjourney gives you a possibility to adjust the prompt before submitting it. But for this study, I just skipped any modifications to see what we can get by default. For the first test, I fed Midjourney its own generations to see how it will decode itself. The same images went to CLIP Interrogator. Let's compare the results. Equally nice, even though I like Midjourney's version a bit more. Sometimes Midjourney would find artists it doesn't know. Tiffany Kelly is not known to Midjourney, and her name doesn't affect the generation. I tried. So it's a big question. Where MJ gets these names from? Where Midjourney's describe is structurally and visually close to the original, CLIP Interrogator brought us the magical Midlibrary. Still, describe wins. It's absolutely fantastic how both models could get these intricate details right. Midjourney's version is beautiful and interesting, but the victory is CLIP Interrogator's. Sorry, describe. You could have at least noticed it's winter out there. Funnily enough, in this round, Midjourney didn't recognize any of the artists from the original prompts, from its own generations. For the next test, I picked several famous works of art. And that's what happened. Well, they both tried at least. Both models work quite well with classical photography. This fantastic double portrait by Gus Zander, for instance. Although CLIP Interrogator missed the color of the dresses. Then I tried the Zaha Hadid's architecture. And once again, a photograph returned excellent results. But it's not just photographs. Here, the classical drawing by Leonardo da Vinci, which both Describe and CLIP Interrogator got right. The more complexity there is in the initial image, the more challenging it becomes for both our test subjects, with a minor supremacy of Describe. And vice versa, obviously. The simpler the source material, the better the output. This dependency becomes especially clear when your input is a simple 2D illustration. I would say that in this round, both contestants showed equal abilities. Now, let's shift from famous to less known works of art. And by that I mean, let's ask Midjourney and CLIP Interrogator to describe some of my photographs. Of course, I couldn't help but start with a portrait of Francis D. Both portraits seem to be equally far or close to the original. And now, let's see how Describe and CLIP Interrogator compare when interpreting images that are more complex and less obvious. CLIP Interrogator is so much closer to the original collage. Both Describe and CLIP Interrogator expanded the image, going from details to full camera picture. However, CLIP Interrogator was closer color-wise. To be honest, I didn't expect any closeness for this group portrait. And yes, both results are pretty far from the original photo. Which one do you think interprets the source material better? Let me know in the comments. Here is a digital collage I made as a sketch for one of my photographic projects. And both contestants failed to reproduce the scene. Here, I love both results, even though Describe and CLIP Interrogator couldn't really get the colors right. Here, the Describe and CLIP Interrogator results are stunningly similar to each other, and somewhat close to the original. Nice! For our next test, let's pick four iconic movie scenes as source images. Both models did great with Blade Runner 2047, but started failing on the seemingly simple next ones. And even though they both managed to capture the Titanic's romantic atmosphere, the composition suffered in the process. And seems like CLIP Interrogator knows Jack Nicholson's iconic role better. Okay, it's a fantastic game that I personally can play forever. This video can't be long enough. But apart from having fun, what can we use Describe for? To describe pictures, Midjourney would mostly use words that it knows and can visually interpret. So, in the most cases, if Midjourney used a word, an expression, or a style modifier, we can use it too, in our own prompts. And the same goes to the artists that Midjourney finds in your images, oftentimes mistakenly. Every name in an output prompt means, in most cases, that Midjourney knows this artist. And you can use it to find out which names work better for the style that you are going for. At Midlibrary, we're all for sharing knowledge and know-how. We try to disclose every prompt in our studies so that you can learn and expand your Midjourney toolbox. With Describe and CLIP Interrogator, you can reverse engineer prompts from any image. My hope is that it will somehow make people less secretive about their prompts. For an artist, Describe and CLIP Interrogator are a creative goldmine. You want to see your visual piece of art reinterpreted? look at it from a new perspective, or see how else it is possible to develop your work further, these tools are for you. The describe function is an absolute gift to a Midjourney artist. It allows to go deeper, do more, extract new prompting strategies and style modifiers, and learn new artists' names. As anything in this world, describe is not perfect. It works great with simple source material, but struggles with complex images. It misses to recognize the artist whose styles Midjourney used to generate the source images. The prompts that describe returns are often messy, overcomplicated, and make no sense. Also, as its users, Midjourney tends to generate a lot of punks and cores that don't exist. Avocado punk, bug core, bibliopunk, frog core, meat punk, and my favorite, grandparent core. Still, it works, and works well. Maybe for now CLIP Interrogator seems to be more advanced. In many cases, it returns more precise and more interesting results. But it exists for a long time. For this video, for example, I used its second version, whereas Describe has just been introduced. There is no doubt that it will learn, develop, and become better with time. So, keep an eye on it. If you liked what you've heard and seen, please support us by subscribing to this channel, liking and sharing this video. This will help us grow and create better educational content. Thank you, and happy Midjourneys!